Both armies race to Spotsylvania. The Confederates get there first and entrench. In this area, Union troops fight with the Confederates. It is here that Union General Sedgwick is killed. There are many markers in this area. On May 12th, Confederate pickets are overwhelmed by 20,000 Union troops here at the Landrum House. All the remains of the house are the chimney bases. Union troops will enter this field under the cover of a thick fog and move toward the Confederate trenches. Monuments mark the locations of Union troops. The battle here at Bloody Angle will last for 20 hours and will be the most intense hand-to-hand fighting of the entire war. Union monuments line what remains of the Confederate trenches known as Bloody Angle. A 22-inch thick oak tree stood here. It was cut down by musket fire. The Confederate entrenchment ran near the tree line. The shallow trenches and mounds of dirt are all that remain of the entrenchments. Here at the McCool House site, Confederate troops form for a counterattack. General Lee again begins to lead his troops into battle, but is asked to go to the rear. All that remains of the McCool House is the foundation. This is the Harrison House site. All the remains of the house are the chimney bases. The National Park Service has a small section of rebuilt entrenchments so that visitors can get a feel for what it was like to be a Civil War soldier. There is also a battlefield exhibit shelter with information about this battle.